Hello, hello, mic test. And yes, now we are actually talking. Net profit is 95.13, CAGR is close to 30%. Maximum drawdown is very small, and yes, we have made a great strategy using the three-layer backtesting at Tradomate.one. It was as simple as starting with the already existing example strategy at Tradomate.one, and actually we improved it significantly to make a really good strategy. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritwik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you are here to make the best MACD trading strategy, then you're in the right place. In this video, I will use Tradomate.one platform to start with the already existing example strategies on MACD and then eventually improve it with the three-layer backtesting available on the platform to make it really good. So guys, if you are new to my YouTube channel, on this channel I turn my YouTubers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to making trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, and yes, making some great trading strategies. So if this is something that you are interested in, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel, and I bet you that watching my videos will improve your skill sets significantly. But before that, a quick disclaimer. Guys, this is not a recommended trading or investment strategy. Please do proper research before putting real money into this particular or any trading strategies. This is just an educational video. Neither me or Tradomate.one is giving any recommendation through this video. Perfect. So let's jump to the platform directly. The website is Tradomate.one. The link is in the description section. This is the web page, and you just click here, get started for free if you have not yet opened your account, and do a normal sign up, maybe through Google as well. If you have watched my last videos, guys, you already know this, that this platform is owned by me. I started up this company called Tradomate.one with Yashu and Satyam. And yes, it is now VC backed. We are making this particular platform for traders like you. Post you sign up, you'll see this particular screen. If you have not yet made any bots on the website, you will be asked to start with the first bot itself. I made one bot already, so you can see it on the dashboard. The documentation page is this one. It's very easy to understand. You can see my video as well here on the walkthrough video of this particular platform. And over here you'll see Discord community, which is something that we are calling Tradomate Army. This is a place where there are like already many traders interacting with each other and with the Tradomate team to improve their trading strategies. So this is the place that you should be coming for sure. Engage with the community and let's make this platform really good. Perfect. So let's create a new bot. I'll just click on create new bot. It asks me to pick Python bot creator. Very soon we'll be launching our rule-based logic creator and then generative AI strategy builder. So yes, stay tuned to that. Right now we have Python bot creator. Let's click on proceed. These are the some of the example strategies that are already provided by the platform. Again, these are by no way any recommendation. Right? These are just some example strategies to start your building your trading strategy. As I mentioned in this video, I am actually focusing on MACD strategy. So let's pick the MACD strategy here. I'll just select this one and click on proceed. Perfect. Now it's asking, which stock should I be considering? Let's go with, in the last few videos, I use ITC, Infosys, and I think TCS, right? If I'm not wrong, let's pick something different. Let's pick ICICI Bank in this example. You can actually pick any US stocks as well. Over there, we have Indian stocks, US stocks, and cryptocurrencies. So perfect. This is the candlesticks chart of ICICI Bank. Over here, you'll see the ticker, the exchange, the currency that it trades into. This is the candlesticks interval. So for example, if I select 4 hours, it refreshes and you'll see the 4 hours interval candlesticks chart. Here we can recenter it to the last candle. Perfect. Over here you will see the entire strategy, MACD strategy in this example. You can see that the first line is import Tradomate as TM. So we actually have an inbuilt in-house library called Tradomate, and all the functionalities that you would need to make a trading strategies is available in just one Python library. You don't need to import any other thing here, right? The first function is the one where you provide your inputs. In this example, we have initial capital, quantity, fast length, slow length, and MACD length, right? The second function, which is this one, is a place where we provide all the information about our trading strategy. So what we are doing here is we are calculating MACD, right? We can calculate it using this way, or you can actually directly get MACD technical indicator from the Tradomate library directly. I'll do it in a second. Right over here, we have some entry and exit conditions, and we are just plotting some of the things. A great feature of this platform is that you can actually consider overlay is equal to true or false for different things. So in this case, we have selected overlay is equal to false for all of them. Right now here, in order to calculate MACD, what we are doing is TM, which is the library, Tradomate, dot TA, which is technical analysis, dot EMA, and then we are calculating MACD using this particular method, which is the basic formula of MACD. What we could also have done is this one, MACD is equal to TM dot TA dot MACD. We have a function directly, and then provide all the information like what is the source, data dot close, for example, what is the fast period. Right, we have already provided fast period here, so I'll just copy this, paste it here, comma. What is the slow period? Again, this is over here. I'll copy this, paste it, comma. Signal period, which is this one, length. Right, I'll again copy this and paste it here. And yeah, that's it. This would be, I would say, having the same thing that we have actually calculated here. So it's absolutely fine. We can do it in either ways. So I'll just go with the one that is already provided, which is this one. Perfect. So let's do one thing. I'm not making any changes. Right, let's just directly save and run. Let's see what are the results. Cool. So as per the results, we can see we have some net profit of very small amount, which is 0.08%. CAGR is 0.03%. Maximum drawdown is also very small. Win rate and profit factor, etc. So the reason this is happening is because we are just trading quantity is equal to 1. So, and the share price of Infosys of ICICI Bank is around 1000, so we should be increasing it to say 40. So this will actually increase all these things. What else? The second thing is I will change the fast length to a bit more faster. So let's do 7 1 week. Increase we can just keep it like this also, or maybe like we can just, let's increase a bit by a few. Let's make it 29. MACD length is this one only. Let's not make any changes. And now let's save and run. So the reason I reduced the fast length is I want more trades to be happening such that I can actually do some more iterations, and eventually the number of trades will go down. So let's start with doing something which increases the number of trades. As we can see, we've already started doing pretty well. The net profit is 30.28%. CAGR is 10.27%. Not very good. Still, if I am trading, I would need at least 20% plus CAGR. So yeah, I'll still need to do something here. Right. The number of trades 93, which is pretty good. I would like it to be more, but yeah, let's. I think this is good. What else? I will go a bit down, and other things look pretty good now. In order to understand this particular strategy in detail, I would have to go through the entire 3-layered backtesting approach at Tradomate.one. This is the first layer. All the results that you're seeing on the right side is the first layer of backtesting. To see the second and third layer, I'll just click on proceed to next step and in-depth backtesting. Proceed. This is the second layer. We have equity curve in front of us. You can see some volatility, right? It was doing pretty well in the beginning, and then we had a small down, which is fine. Then we again covered it up. And significantly, we had a couple of big trades which have significantly reduced the net profit. So this is the place that I need to work on. Maybe this, something major happened. I think this is the time when we had election results mostly. Probably some of the things that we need to do in some of the areas for which, let's plan something. I'll just click on the risk and ratio analysis. Right, the Sharpe ratio is greater than 0, which is decent. Sortino is 1.34, which is quite good actually. Beta is also pretty well. I don't think here we need to do anything significant. The gross loss has been minus 65.53. The gross profit is 45.36. It means that we definitely had a couple of huge losses. That's the reason that the gross loss has increased that much. Let's close this. I will go to the orders now in order to see what all different trades we are doing. So let's see which are all the places where actually we are making huge negative trades. So minus 2%, minus 3%, minus 3%, minus 5%. This is huge. This is somewhere around 3 to 4 June. If we go down, I think that was the time when we had the election results, right? Minus 3-4%. We had a great profit here, which is a long strategy, 29th of November. Exit on 13th of December, which is pretty good. If we scroll down a bit more, you can see some, I would say, green and red numbers here. I would say a lot of red numbers. So we need to work on improving the win factor a bit if it's possible. So this is good. Let's do one thing. I'll run the scenario analysis as well. Or we could clearly see that we need to actually have a stop loss and mostly a take profit as well. So I'll just click on the edit strategy, and let's on this particular code, I will provide the stop loss config.slpct, which is stop loss percent. What it should be, let's do 2%. Config.tp, which is take profit PCT, is equal to what should be the risk reward ratio. Let's do 1:3. So it would be 6%. Now here I'll have to make some changes. Stop loss percent is equal to this one. Take profit percent is equal to this one, as simple as that. I'll copy this entire thing and paste it here. Right, let's save and run. Let's see what are the results. Perfect. So yeah, we have made some improvement. The CAGR has gone up a bit, not much, but I think we have a strict need of stop loss and take profit, so I'll keep it. Let's proceed to the next step. I'm interested to see the second and third layer metrics as well. Second layer is something that we have already talked about. Again, some big downfalls here, so we still need to do something here. The standard deviation is around 10.14. Sharpe ratio is now close to 1%, which is good. I would just directly go to the scenario analysis and will select the most in demand feature that we have at Tradomate.one, which is market trend. By the time it's running, basically what it will do is it will split your strategy in three different parts. What happened at the time of bullish time, what happened at the time of bearish time, and what happened at the time of sideways market. And this is how we get an understanding if our trading strategy is only biased toward any particular market trend. We have the results now, but this is the feature that people are loving, this particular thing. And there are many traders who are just coming to Tradomate.one just to check out their trading strategy if it is biased towards any particular trend. So as we can see here on this strategy as well, this blue graph is our actual equity curve. Yellow, red, and green are basically sideways, bearish, and bullish time. If you just go here, clearly if you can see, this is the trend. This is the downfall that we saw in the bullish time. Although we, at the time of election results, the prices went down significantly. But that, like before that, it was a bullish time. So still, we should be considering it as a bullish period only. So this is the place that we are losing money. If we go here, we are doing pretty well in the sideways market, which is 25.1%. In the bearish time also, it's 12.32%, which is pretty good. Bullish time is something that we need to work on, which is minus 2.79%. If you click on see all, clearly the CAGR is negative in the bullish time. Maximum drawdown is also decently high at the time of bullish time. My win rate is average. Profit factor is average. Number of trades 81, which means that there was a lot of bullish time. So we need to actually make the changes very smartly, because we don't want to impact our trading at the time of bullish time, because we have seen a significant bullish trend in ICICI Bank stocks. So what actually I would do here is I can clearly see that I'm actually doing pretty well in the sideways market. So I would like to milk it as much as possible. So low volatility is good. Right, if the volatility is high, it means like bullish or bearish time, I would be a bit cautious. If the volatility is low, I'm absolutely fine with that. So I will have one indicator or one filter of volatility. Second thing is I like the trend as well, because in the bearish time we actually made some good money. So I would keep one indicator of which follows trend also, so which can be ADX, for example. So one thing on volatility and one thing on ADX, which is basically following the trend, is something that I would like to do in the trading strategy, which is the insight that I got from the third layer market trend analysis. I'll click on edit strategy. Cool. I'll go down a bit here. Right. Let's provide volatility calculation. Perfect. So for volatility calculation, I would go with the high of the candle and compare it with the low of the candle. I would say, let's say, three candles before that one. So high change is equal to data dot last high divided by, say, data dot low dot I log and -3, -1. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm comparing the last high candle with the three candles ago low. Similar to this, I will compare the low as well. which is data dot last low divided by data dot high dot I log, same thing, which is minus 3 and then minus 1. This would be negative, so let's multiply this entire thing with minus 1, so both of them would be positive. High change and high low, this should not be significant, so we'll just write vol condition. Now the first one, which is high change, should not be greater than say 0.035, which is 3.5%, or same thing here, which is low change, should not be greater than 0.035, which is 3.5%. Now this should not be, I'm saying should not be, so we will have to make it this way. So this is the condition and not vol condition, right? Same goes with this one as well. That's one, right? Now in order to capture the trend as well, I will have a simple, not very strict ADX condition. So ADX is equal to tm dot ta dot adx, and then source high is equal to data dot high, source low is data dot low, source close is data dot close, and period is, let's keep it 14 only. ADX condition is equal to, let's keep ADX is greater than ADX dot I lock minus 1, which is the last ADX value, should be greater than equal to, let's keep it, keep a small number, say 11, right? I don't want to make a very strict condition on ADX, and ADX condition, the same thing goes here as well for the short situation. Right, here, because we are making some money, we can actually increase the quantity. Let's make it 65. And I think everything looks pretty good here. Pretty good here. So save and run. And yes, now we are actually talking. Net profit is 95.13. CAGR is close to 30%. Maximum drawdown is very small. And yes, we have made a great strategy using the three-layer backtesting at Tradomate.one. It was as simple as starting with the already existing example strategy at Tradomate.one. And actually, we improved it significantly to make a really good strategy that we should be proud of. So yes, I think that this is it for this video. We can do more changes to make it pretty good. We can see the number of trades has also gone up significantly. So yeah, I think let's end this video. This is your homework to keep on working to make it even better, and let me know in the comment section. If you liked even one thing about this video, guys, click on the like button. This is really good for the YouTube algorithm, and also hit on the subscribe button and the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are coming on this YouTube channel. And as I mentioned at the beginning, I bet you that you would learn a lot here for free. This is a playlist on Tradomate.one, and I'll make 6 videos on different types of trading strategies on how to improve it using this platform. So yeah, the next video will be on some other trading strategy, so stay tuned. If you have any recommendation for the next video, again, please let me know in the comment section. And yeah, with this, don't forget to join the Discord community, which is Tradomate Army community, and interact with the great professional traders that are already talking with each other on the community. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there, you'll see this entire playlist on Tradomate.one, and over there, you'll see this walkthrough video of Tradomate.one. Keep learning, keep financial programming, and I'll see you in the next video very, very soon. Until then, peace.